United States wanted to make it clear that our space program was a civil effort and scientific effort. President Eisenhower was concerned that our efforts in space exploration and research would be consolidated and made more effective.
NASA is to become part of a new agency, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration. You can be justly proud of the fact that your past achievements have made NACA the choice of all governmental agencies out of which to build the new agency.
The NACA starts taking a look at particularly high-speed flight as part of aeronautics, but that quickly blends into space research. They start using rockets to do high-speed research on airplanes and then eventually on re-entry vehicles. The NACA is really sort of this repository of aerospace scientific skill and also aerospace geekdom as well, I suppose, to some extent. People who are very interested in flight and, of course, naturally space as well. So that sort of sets them up to become the core of NASA.
So the transition between the two organizations was like seamless in that sense. The technicians were superb. The people that you had mentoring you were just superb. So with the early days, then the attitude was still, let's get the job done.
NASA must be like NACA in the qualities of strength and character that make an organization great.
Today, a new moon is in the sky, a 23-inch metal sphere placed in orbit by a Russian rocket.
Political pressure builds rapidly in the United States. And there are hearings in Congress. There's calls for the United States to do something dramatic. And a lot of pressure gets put on Vanguard.
The first American attempt with a Vanguard rocket was a failure.
We were having mostly explosions with our rockets. It seemed like 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, blow up more than lift off back in those days.
We've been assigned the mission of launching a scientific Earth satellite. I promised the Secretary of the Army that we would be ready in 90 days or less.
The news media had found out about the fact that we were going to launch a satellite, and I heard there was something like 200 news media came in. At one time, they measured the jet stream wind at 227 miles an hour over the Cape. Well, of course, it would have driven the rocket off course. Range safety would have blown it up immediately. The next day, my calculation showed there was a wave in the jet stream. By evening, there would be a window of opportunity. I convinced him that probably would do it, and so then he said, okay, well, listen to the kid, go fuel a rocket, and things went well.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, by command, by command.
A project like firing a satellite into orbit is only possible if there's splendid teamwork all the way through.
There were scientists all around the world that were dedicated to trying to understand the planet better. And this is what Explorer 1 was really designed for. One of the things that I find very noble about NASA, and I think it's really useful to remember, is it started with science. We wanted to observe the Earth from space, and we wanted to see what the environment right up above the Earth was like. And this is the incredible thing. The first time we venture up there, we discover something completely unexpected, the Van Allen radiation belts. And there were these radiation belts of particles from the sun trapped in our magnetic field. We hadn't even guessed that they were there yet.
The purpose of the work is a scientific one, and it's very nearly pure scientific experimentation. The more we understand about our the nature of our astronomical environment and about our own Earth, it's quite likely the more we'll be able to do about it and do with it.
We have one of the most challenging assignments that has ever been given to modern man. Expansion of human knowledge about space. Development and operation of vehicles capable of carrying instruments and man through space. long-range studies of the benefits of using aeronautical and space activities for peaceful and scientific purposes. Preservation of the role of the United States as a leader in aeronautical and space science and technology. We have a mighty big job to do.